After a wobbly start, Philippine shares led the charge in Asia after data showed U.S. inflation further eased 6.5%, the slowest in a year, setting the Federal Reserve on track to downshift its rate hikes. The PSEI surged 1.7% to break above the 6,900 level and close at its highest in nearly a year. Trading Edge's Ron Acoba says the next few weeks will reveal whether the bulls can win over the bears.
It appears to be that the PSEI is on the verge of pivoting from a notable base, a positive pivot seen in the regional indices like the emerging market Asia index and the MSCI Philippines index, and even the peso dollar exchange rate all suggest that the bulls may finally take control.
Regina Capital's Ariel Santos says the market could test the 7,000 level, but she wouldn't be surprised to see some profit taking now.
Should this happen, it would just be a healthy pullback, therefore opening some buying opportunities for the other investors and not a trend reversal. Based on the current market movement, I would say that technically it's not that impossible to hit 7,000 in the next couple of trading days, although I wouldn't say that, or I wouldn't expect that the index would actually settle around 7,000. Perhaps it's just going to be an intraday visitation.
Meanwhile, bond market PDEX head Nino Nakpil shares. The bond market has seen its fair share of revenge issuance from companies, with 2022 seeing record debt capital raising.
This is really domestic investor strength. No, the domestic investor strength really fully, because whatever the issuers needed, the investor came up and said, okay, the funds are available. Mm-hmm. And notable for all of those issuance, we had 30 listing events last year, and more than that in the number of securities that were issued. Almost all of them were oversubscribed. The tenders exceeded the amounts needed by the issuer. So there's domestic investment liquidity now, that's capable. That's a positive sign.